Oh, Phil, these last few weeks have been the best of my life.
Gamas!
Oi! What the hell is this? You been drinking again?
Oh, we won.
Have ya?
We won from
it. Have you been drinking again? Have ya?
Phil, it's not what it looks like.
Shut up, you monk!
You should have known better. Bye, Phil.
Back, pump, whole city.
Don't expect much from my penalties.
Oh, that's true.
Go on, Bruni!
Alexis Sanchez, Arsenal legend.
Cathy Sweeney, Mrs. Van Legend.
Garvey, Inburn's finest.
Is that Charlie Adam? Oh! Oh! Oh!
Caitlyn Jenner of the Kardashians.
Try and hit a crossbar.
You get one shot.
If you don't stand in a line.
Pressure.
Oh, what? Nate trying to hit the bar still. I don't know.
He's got it.
Secret than I can tell mine. I bake. What? I love to bake. Strudel, scones, even apple pan dowdy. Not another sound. Someday I hope to make the perfect creme brulee.
For this awesome sensation, but I'm ready to let it lie.
wants to be a singer, then I'm coming clean. I play the cello.
Awesome.
What is it?
A song?
No, dude, it's like a giant violin.
Not another word.
Do you have to wear a costume?
Cut and tie.
I'm Grant Hill, this is Lee Farrelly, and this is our accent challenge. In you go.
No, si mi amo, this Donald Trump ese. He want to build a wall between me and your country. You're at US Border Patrol. You already shoot my mama.
I think I could match up.
Could you though?
Yeah, amigo, it's not so safe to go down there, man. They call that Caño del Diablo, in Devil's Caña.
Danny Trejo in the room.
Yeah. Yes, 1-0. My flyman name is Mitchell, and I'm from Australia, and I'm from a place called Summer Bay. And, well, Summer Bay is a made up place, so I'll do what I want.
You see, years ago, me and my family came down from Little Canterbury, but my family descended from criminals, so we got shipped over to Sydney.
Sorry.
I lived there since. A bit of an adrenaline junkie, I like to climb the Sydney Harbour Bridge. My friend, he fell one time and he landed on a shark. He survived, you know, we're Australian, we survived the toughest battles.
Point each, right, okay, I thought it was pretty good. Right. Well, I was out in my back garden planting my seeds for the spring, and what I see coming over is a big ass Cadillac, and it's flying over my garden, and I'm like, damn, man. And I call my little son, Brandon, and he's like, Mama, what's that? And I'm like, it's a Cadillac, Brandon, it's a Cadillac. And then, you know, it's just crazy. So Brandon, you go tell them what happened. Mama, you didn't say there was no Cadillac. You just said it was Uncle Jeremiah thinking he could fly again. Boy, get your ass inside. I'm trying to buy myself a new Eddie Murphy comedy DVD, and I'm gonna get my dollars for getting this interview right. So you get your ass inside. Right now.
Oh, man. It's raining a little white, baby. My prayers have been answered. But you better move, because my other prayer's for a Cadillac.
Two, did Lee win that?
Oh, you try to see.
Hey Joey, come on, what are you doing? I'm walking here. You know, you should just sit down right now. You don't want to do that? Okay. I'm gonna break your legs though.
You come over here, you want to disgrace my family name? You don't want to come here? Being all big ass tough guy? You're lucky I don't put you in concrete boots, put you down the Hudson.
Hey, pretty good. Who wins that?
Disrespectful.
3-2.
Stara Zvotia, he's not unnatural for us Russians to drink vodka, you know? I think maybe, you know, Vladimir Putin is the best president we have ever had, but other people think he's Joseph Stalin, but I do not think so. You know, it's not personal, it's just business, no?
Back in my day, the Soviet Union, it was great. A brilliant union. We had East Germany, we had everything we could ask for, all the vodka we needed. And then democracy came along. It ruined my family's life. My mother, God bless her soul. She used to be a beet farmer. Biggest beard in the village. But the stress took hold of her and she shaved her beard.
3-3.
Hey fam, what you doing in it? I'll spark you out in it. Don't even say anything to me fam, cause you know what? I'll get my boys down. You know, I'm from Croydon in it. All my boys, they hard men. They gonna shank you, innit? You say anything in me, and I'll tell you shut up, innit? Come on, guys.
Try and match that, innit?
Kill 12! Kill 12!
East London life.
Kill 12, man! You think doing? Shut up!
Oh, Jesus! I almost got pushed off my seat.
Four.
That's me in the running race.
My name is Johnny Russell, and in my spare time, I like to hunt chickens, and I like to make stew with them, you know. But I go up Locklow Hill, and when I try to catch the chickens, I'm very scared of them, but I almost got my ring finger taken off. And my dad said that I can't get married because I don't use my right hand. I'd only put my ring finger on my left hand. But Locklow Hill, if you want a wee chicken chase, it's the best place for you.
Hey, Kim, you can't tell me what to do again. I was on the X3 down in Edinburgh, going Pencil Street, had to go back up 205. I ended up getting the wrong bus. I was in the city like Dr. Mukti. And I didn't know where to go. I got off the bus like, this isn't 5, this is Dr. Mukti. What did I do here? You can.
For each. Woo! You look like a pop star. You sing like a pop star. You're going to be a pop star. No, I'm late in all serious, mate. Right. You can't say anything about Sinead O'Connor, right? I'm telling you right now, Sinead O'Connor is a legend to Ireland. And I'm telling you, what was that album called again? I think it's on here. Oh. The Lion and the Cobra is a great album, right? Don't even say it's not. My dad is a hard man, and he's gonna kick you and kick your whole family. And I'm telling you, if you don't like Sinead O'Connor, you don't like my dad. And my dad is a hard man. And your family, and your family, and your family are gonna be kicked.
This is going to you, Junkie George Ice. Yeah, junkies. You see, I told her I never had a son. I've never been no donor. And you cried into Morganti's face. You cried, like a little girl.
I'm not allowed to.
Now, I'm glad these boys are out carried by and by first. Right, first, I want Davy first, and your son John. Now, I'm not going to skip the queue.
He's talking about Gypsy Files, I think.
Yeah, it was
a Gypsy Files. Hey, 5-4. Is that me? Can we do one more special one?
If you want.
Okay, we've got
to... Wait, you need to celebrate first.
Hey, fam. Shake my hand.
Hey.
Yeah. Best man win. Hey. Right, we're going to do
still
one.
Still crap, though.
That was pretty terrible, wasn't it? It was pretty terrible. I'm not even going to sit and deny that.
Gay German.
Oh, that was so good. That is so good, man. Hello, I'm Bruno, and I'm from Austria. It's called Thierry, Vienna. No big deal, was ever. You know, Berlin is like such an amazing city. And, you know, I go there for my holidays every single summer. And then I go to Berlin, you know, it's like, wow, look at that. Look at all the sexy men. And my heart stops a little, you know? Like, I feel it about to burst out my chest.
I'm going to forfeit this.
I'm palpitating right now, just thinking about it. That's been an accent challenge and the best man won, sorry. So, yeah.
I'd like this opportunity to apologise to my family, my friends. I've liked it.
So, yeah.
It's honoured my heritage.
See ya.
Okay, guys, what are you guys getting to drink?
I don't know what to get. I've never been here before.
Well, I'm here all the time. I'll get the orange soda, so get the orange soda.
Okay.
Can I get an orange soda, please?
Can I have a strawberry soda, please?
Me too. Strawberry soda, please.
Seriously, you guys, that is so rude. Like, why would you do that?
Strawberry's better.
Seriously, that's a joke. Like, why did you not get the orange soda? I told you to get the orange soda. Like, you are supposed to be my sisters. Like, how could you betray me like this? Like, seriously?
Shut up, Kim.
Kim, would you stop taking pictures? Your sister's going to jail.
I want to get a picture in the moment. Take a picture.
Because being with the plastic was like being famous. People looked at you all the time, and everybody just knew stuff about you.
That new girl from here came from Africa. Darcy bought army pants and flip-flops, so I bought army pants and flip-flops.
That Darcy girl's so hot, she might even be hotter than Amy Runcie.
Are we getting James?
We'll get Carsey first, okay?
Cool.
Right.
Hi!
Hi!
Hey. Right, we're going to get James?
Yeah.
Right, you ready?
Yeah, let's do
this.
Let's do this!
When you hold me in the street and you kiss me on the dance floor.
Stop that, mate.
I can't do it.
I wish that it could be like that.
Oh my god, a traffic jam.
Oh yes, really crowded here.
Oh. Since we're here for a while, are you excited to leave school?
Yeah, I'm so excited. Like, I can't wait. I'm
genuinely.
I can't wait.
Buzzing.
You buzzing? Yeah, I'm buzzing. Mm-hmm.
Buzzing. Are you excited to leave?
Obviously.
What would you miss?
What will I miss? I don't think I've missed much, if I'm being honest.
Okay.
I don't know. Maybe the people.
Probably the people.
Definitely not the schoolwork.
I feel like the good vibes from our year.
Yeah, good vibes, good.
Good vibes. So what it's going to do?
Or quite a lot crazy people. Well, I'm hoping to go to college.
Oh, so. Look at you.
Look at me. Yeah, if I do well on the exams this year, to be fair. Probably not going to happen.
I've got uni. So ooh. Yeah. I'm just moving away, I'm gonna fly the next.
We're moving again, guys. We should get music.
Your words cut deeper than a knife. I need someone to breathe me back to life.
Like some CPR.
Got a feeling that I'm going under. But I know that I'll make it out alive. Quick on you, my lover. Move on. You watch me leave it till I can't breathe. Shaking, falling onto my knees. And now that I'm without your kisses, I'll be needing stitches. Tripping over myself. Aching, begging you to come help. And now that I'm without your kisses, I'll be needing.
Jam.
Needle in the bag, gotta get you out of my head. Needle in the bag, gonna hurt some dick. Needle in the bag, gotta get you out of my head. Needle in the bag, gonna wind up dead.
James just texted me.
What?
He's gonna be late tonight, so.
Typical.
See that,
typical.
James? You can never trust a man.
Ridiculous.
Well, I guess we gotta go home now.
Yep.
I have no clue. Do you want a Haribo, by the way? I stole it from somebody's like bag of Haribos that are like sitting on the table next to a bag. So I think the Corys are Jamie's, so I like took like a massive handful.
If you could say thanks to one S6, who would it be and why?
I want to say thanks to Louise Guthrie. You've been my best pal since nursery, and we've been through primary and high school together. And I just want to say thanks. And do you remember that time that we did an aeroplane and I'm on top of you and then I go flying into the wall? Yeah, I remember that too, thanks.
Hannah, probably. This is so funny. I don't know. Just been best pals for ages.
Chloe Fraser. Because she got me through advanced higher maths. Wouldn't have done that otherwise.
Right, okay.
So, if you could say thanks to
1A6,
who would it be?
Right, okay, I need to think of Amanda. Well, I better say Lauren or she'll probably greet. I'd say thanks to Lauren for putting up with me for 17 years, even though everyone thinks we're lesbians. Are we allowed to say that?
I can say it if you want.
Because it's not like they're like, oh, that's disgusting. No, I'm like, what a f***ing off. Out loud and proud. I'm not really a lesbian. But...
probably to like the squad. Just for being there throughout thick and thin and having many laughs throughout this year.
Neve, because like we've been best pals for like 2 years now, but I just feel like I don't know what I'll do. Like I see her every day, obviously, even at weekends. But I think it's going to be weird not seeing her every day. Yeah, probably her. She makes me laugh in that big part of my life.
probably Kirsty. Rutherford, because she's just always been there for me, I guess, throughout the 6 years that I've known her.
I'd like to thank Kirsty for making me go to the toilet at like 10 at night when we went camping, and then I got locked in the toilet for 10 minutes and I couldn't get out. It's scary.
I'd probably say the squad, because we've always managed to have a laugh through all the bad times.
Right, so Darcy. Why? Because Darcy always has places and chocolate. Oh, it's nerve-wracking.
Probably Eva, to be honest, because she's been there for me since I was in like second year and all that, and I went through a really like sad phase, you know what I mean? And like she was the one that was there for me. And then it was horrible to her. So I'm sorry as well, Eva. Aye, but thanks, Eva.
I would like to thank all my friends. Can we delete that? Okay, so I'd like to thank the fam. No, delete that. Who talks like that, do you know what I mean?
Chloe, definitely. I think we've been friends for so long. But in high school, she's always been there and she's always been my best friend, even when things were difficult.
A shout out to my boys, Erin-Leslie Gannon, Mary Mitchell, Fern Young, Morven Porter and Alana Kenny.
If I was to say thanks to one sexier, it would probably be Alana. Don't need to say why. Right, okay. So the reason I'd say why, thanks, is because, well, I've been with her since nursery and she has made all my school years. She's been my best pal, always been there for me and stuff like that. So no, she's always been reliable. And...
well, I couldn't really thank one, I thank all the guys that I've been with since primary one, all the way up to now. That's Corey, Fraser, Kyle, Jamie Jones in P5. Craig as well came in first year, but I'd like Owen, etc. I'd like to thank them all.
I would say thank you to Greg Edgar for always keeping me sane through like exams and crap. I'm not allowed to say crap anymore.
Aye.
That's out then.
Well, I don't think I could thank one person. I think it just need to be all the boys. So probably Kyle, Ross, Corey, Jamie, Fraser, Owen and Adam.
It'd probably be Alison, because she's always just sort of cheery when I come in, and then so like when it gets hard in school and all that and you get sick of working and Alison's just there sort of plodding along and still going, still smiling and sort of keeps you going as well when she goes with it.
Probably George Wiles and Craig Edgar, because they just get my humour.
I'd have to say Katie Fitzsimmons. Do I need to tell you why? a lot of reasons. I don't know, I just think we've become a lot better friends over the last year, come a lot closer, and we've went to a lot of things together, had a lot of fun, new experiences and everything.
A person I'd like to thank is Fraser Wilson for breaking my VL.
Probably Chloe Fraser. I think she's like, she's a really good pal in general. And like, And though she's always really been there for me, she's a really good person.
What one teacher is most memorable and why?
It would be Miss McTavish. I just want to say thank you for being there over the 6 years. You're a great teacher and you're the reason why I love drama so much and why I want to do it when I leave school. So yeah, thank you very much for being there.
English, therefore, has been Mrs. Dover because she's just banter, isn't it? And she's a good teacher as well. Probably the best teacher in the school, sorry everybody.
It would have to be Miss Dover, I think. I've had her from second to fourth year for English, and I don't know. She made me enjoy the subject, which I never thought would happen. She made me do well on my exam, and just, she was always, could always rely on her if you needed somebody.
I'd say Mr. Joplin, because he was so nice when we went to Austria. We had a lot of fun, had some good chats with Mr. Joplin, he went skiing with us. It's good. It was nice to us when we got back as well.
I like Mrs. Dover because like I had her for English for like 3 years and I don't think I'd like be doing higher English if I didn't have her for like the first 3 years of high school.
Mrs. Dover and Miss Adams because Mrs. Dover Mrs. Dover helped me believe that I was good enough to pass English, and then I walked out with an A band one. And Miss Adams because she just always like kept me going through the school years.
My most memorable teacher is Mrs. Mullen, because she's like a second mum to me. She's been there for everything as well, and she got me my A in National 5 and Higher Admin.
It has been Mrs. Wraith, and my MPS has put up with me now for a good few years. And also a shout out to Mr. Hewitt, who's a very good man.
What is something you always remember about Chryston High School?
Probably like my group of pals, like everyone within my circle. Some teachers, not all, but some I'll remember. And just the atmosphere, like I don't love school, but I enjoy coming. Like it's going to be weird not coming.
Just like stupid wee things that you remember, like Mr. Muir's biscuits in. It's going to be something I'm going to talk about. Oh, my head teacher used to give out biscuits, and the stairs at the corner where you think you're going to die like every day because everyone tries to go up those stairs, and then when you're running late and you're trying to sneak down the stairs you're only supposed to go up, and Mr. McDougall would come out of her class like out of nowhere and start going, "You're not supposed to go down those stairs," and you're like, "It's fine, it's fine." And then Claire at the office when you sign in, obviously. Can't forget Claire.
Yeah, I always remember the school shows and taking part in them, and the drama department just being fab. And the school bus. The school bus, like breaking down like halfway up the hill and think I'm going to die. That I'll always remember that.
One thing I'll always remember about Chryston High School is when Natasha threw dictionaries at Violet's in second year.
Have you ever been shouted at, and what for?
Oh, probably the funniest I got shouted at for was being called a bigot. Because I went go to Celtic Park for like a sports trip.
One reason I got shouted at was flirting with the teacher, Miss Agnew.
What is the funniest moment in Chryston High School?
I'd say Mr. Orr, when he burnt the... When he got like this chemical stuff, he didn't know what he was doing, and then he poured it like burned the full table, and there was a massive hole. And we had to like all go out of the class. It was so funny.
Jennifer and the stairs, they were wet and slippy, and she went down a nice flight of stairs all the way on her backside. That was a good one.
The day we were at the park, winter's day, and Dylan Armitage threw a massive like ice snowball at Katie Dempsey, and she burst out crying, and I think that was the last time we actually were ever at the park.
Probably the like every morning Alana's late for the bus, or she like misses it. There's not like a morning where something doesn't happen.
Ali's been sick in the toilet like 2 weeks ago. That was funny, and she missed the pan, so it was like all over the floor. That was funny.
Probably the panto, specifically the raffle, when I sort of slagged Mr. Muir's wife. But after that, Muir just went, "It's all right." So I just went, "Friend!" over on that side of the hall. everyone was just like, I just heard Tasha Baker's laugh louder than anyone else's.
Probably when we were in the old school and Violet Zangieri smacked Ross in the face and smacked his glasses off and he chased her around the school, tried to batter her. That's quite funny.
Funniest moment at Chryston, gosh, there's been a lot. I'd like to thank... It's a different question, isn't it? Funniest moment was when I was scrapping with Stacey because I caught more than a snake and caused other issues as well. It's good to know we've put it in the past.
Probably one of the funniest times in school was when I nearly battered Sinead for going out with Ross in first year.
In the old school when Craig tried to kick the shutter and ended up basically breaking his neck. It was so funny.
How did you feel when you got a house role?
I was really happy, actually. It was nice to be like recognised as someone that had done things in the school that was worthy of a position and recognition. And it was nice to be able to do stuff and to have, like, be someone that hopefully like younger children could look up to. So yeah, I was very happy.
It was a bit of a surprise, actually, because I didn't vote for me and I wouldn't have voted for me. And then Mr. Kane was like, so how would you feel about being the school captain? And I was like, oh, okay. And I thought it was quite cool because it was like everyone that voted for you, so you guys don't all hate me, which is quite cool. And then I found out like Chris was the captain as well, and it was good because I get on well with him. So we got to like team up and do a couple things through the year, which was quite fun, and I quite enjoyed it.
Can I see it after?
No one's allowed.
Can I not just see mine?
No.
So I can then find me my voice?
No.
Oh, okay. For God's sake.
Gammas! Gammas! Leave me alone!
This makes no sense.
Wait, no, I feel like my leg. Yes. Oh, that's so like,
oh, yeah, there you go. Phil, you've been drinking again.
Oh, Phil, these last few weeks have been the best of my life.
Thomas! What the hell is this? Phil, we've been drinking again.
Oh, Phil, these last few weeks have been the best of my life.
Thomas!
Oh, Phil, these last few weeks have been the best of
do
my
again,
life.
Do it again.
Oh, I don't need to do yet.
Cody, look at my eyes.
Actually, you need that.
You can come on, home.
Again,
hold on, go and turn your f***ing sound up.
I can't.
You can.
Oh. Kim, would you stop taking pictures? Your
wait,
sister?
You can't laugh. You have to laugh.
No, f*** sake, Elgie!
If you see f***ing pictures.
No, I'm not like watching.
Hi, can I get an orange soda, please?
Strawberry's better.
What's that?
Strawberry's better.
I can't do that. I can't.
Strawberry's better.
I can't do that. I can't do that.
Is there a wee cameo there? Hannah, where are you going? You're like away there. No, someone run into them. Action.
I'd like to thank my mum for supporting me. I don't know what to say. I don't like any of these. This is me doing my ice bucket challenge, and I'd like to nominate Erin-Leslie and Morden Porter, Stacey, of course, and Mary and Alana.
Do you like me?
We're leaving.